Hi guys, it's me Ryan and welcome back to my YouTube channel, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to properly thread an overlocker machine. So I personally have the Janome 6234XL overlocker, which I did unbox a few videos back, so if you want to go see that, please go check that out. But today I'm going to be showing you how to thread it. This will apply as well to your overlocker. It might be slightly different depending what brand you have and of course what machine, but it will be kind of a really similar process. So if you guys can take any help from this video whatsoever, it will be really great and my goal is complete. So today I'm going to be showing you how to thread an overlocker. It's not as hard as it looks, and I for one will admit I personally found it really scary when I first opened it and thought, oh my god, how am I going to thread this? But when you actually narrow it down step by step, it is really, really easy. Please do not feel intimidated. Anyone can do it. Sometimes the instruction manual does make it look harder than it is, which for me, when I looked at it, it did look harder. I just found a YouTube video and it was done literally within 5 minutes. So I'm going to show you guys how I do it today. And again, like I said, I hope you can take something from this. If you want to see how to properly thread an overlocker, please keep watching. So as you guys can see, this is my overlocker. Like I said, I own the Janome 6234XL, but like I said, the process will be very similar. So what you're first going to want to do, if you haven't already, is take your cones of thread and place them on your thread stand. I personally use the 5000 meter spools of Coates Moon thread. It is really good and I have had it recommended to me so many times. So just place your spools of thread on your thread stand like so, and now we can start threading. So the first thing you want to do is make sure your machine is off and your presser foot is lifted up so the tension discs across the top are released. Then what you're going to do is start in the order your machine manual tells you to. This machine just goes from right to left, so it is the lower looper, upper looper, right needle and left needle. Let's get started. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to take my tweezer, which should come in your accessory pack of your machine, and I'm going to take the thread that will go in my lower looper. I'm going to take my thread and I'm going to pull it up over the top of my thread stand and through the other side. So if you guys can see, I've pulled it through the top there. It's come up and over and down. And then because that is green, they are all color coded as well on the machines. So once that is done, I'm just gonna pull it down from there with my tweezer, and I'm gonna pull it through the back of this hole here, bring it through to the front, like so. And then I'm going to go back around again, so loop it over, and then I'm going to put it back through a second hole. Like so. And then once that is done, you're just going to want to pull it down in between your tension plates and then down the front of your machine. So once that is done, in order to do the upper looper on the 6234XL, you're going to pull it down and then into this slot here, like so, and then down, and then once that is through there, you're going to go down into the actual mechanisms, I guess, on the machine. Once it's gone down there, I'm going to take the thread and I'm going to pull it around this tension disc thing here, and then I'm going to take it and put it down through this green dot here. As I said, they're all color coded, so pull that through there. My hands are very shaky, like that. And now the good thing about the 6234XL is it actually has a lower looper easy thread mechanism. So what I'm going to do is pull the things forward. And then this little hook thing here, if I push that way, see that pops out there, and then the lower looper pops out there, which makes it extremely easy to be able to thread this. So I'm gonna go again through there, and then through here, because because it's also labeled green. Like so. And then I'm going to go up and around this desk thing. The other one. And then once that's done there, once that's there, I'm just going to bring it up, hook it around this little thing here, if I can get it in there, like so. See, that's hooked around the top there. And then take the end and pull it through the hole in the lower looper there. Pull it towards the back, like that. And then just pull it back behind and under the presser foot. And that is the lower looper threaded. So once the lower looper is done, you're going to want to repeat the same steps at the top. I'm going over the rail thing through the two holes at the top, whatever process it is for your machine. You're going to want to bring it down through the tension disc. You go through this guide here for the upper looper, I mean, on this model. Then you're just going to take, this is a much more simple process I find than the lower looper. Then you're going to take your end and you're going to put it through this guide right here. Again, they're all color coded, and pull that through. And then you're just simply going to take it and put it around this notch thing here, this little metal thing, hook it around there. You're going to pull it through your upper looper hole, which is just there. So pull it up around this tension disc thing, and I'm just going to move that up and then take the end. I actually like to snip the end of mine because it makes it sharper, which is easier to put through the eye, and then just pull it through there just like you did the lower looper. My thread is through the looper right here, and I'm just going to pull it back under my presser foot, just like I did with my lower looper. And that is the upper looper and the lower looper of the Janome 6234XL threaded. Again, it will be a very similar process for your machines you guys have at home. So again, with the needles, very similar at the beginning, pull it up through the thread stand thing from the back to the front, and then pull it through the two holes at the back, making sure that they loop. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about because I have moved the camera, just go back to the lower looper and you will see exactly what I mean. You repeat this process exactly the same for all of them, just making sure it is the right thread with the right one, because it's all color-coded. Again, down through the tension discs down here. But now, obviously, we don't have to go down into the machine. So, as you can see, color-coded. So with the right needle, you're just going to take it up around here, and then up here, and then around this point here, like so. And then right here, just above the needle, you're gonna, it's like two hoops, and for the right needle, you're gonna put it in the right needle hoop, and then around the little bar above the needles, just like your sewing machine. And then take the end like so and thread it through the eye of the needle. This machine does come with a needle threader, but I don't use it because I don't really find it useful. Again, straight through the eye of the needle, like so, and pull it back, and again under your presser foot, making sure it doesn't get caught in anything like your blade. And then once that's done, you can pull it back, and there is your right needle threaded. So now for the left needle, you're going to do the exact same process at the top, through your thread guide thing, through the two holes, again through the tension disc. Always make sure your threads are in the tension discs, because otherwise you will not sew properly. Then again, up under this thing, then over that, through the left needle hole this time, and then behind the bar, and then again tick the end, and just thread it through the eye of your needle. Once that's done, again pull it back under your presser foot, making sure it's not caught on anything. My nose gets caught on the blade. Pull it back and it's under. And then once you have all four threads underneath, and once that's all done, put your press foot down and then just chain off slowly to create a chain. And as you can see, it starts chaining and then you're ready to put your fabric under and sew. That is how you thread your overlocker. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. If you did find this video helpful or take anything from this, do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit that notification bell for when I upload future videos. And please be sure to comment down below video ideas you guys want to see, any feedback you have for me. And again, thank you so much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.